Welcome back, and in this video I want to talk about template and pseudo parameters, two types of parameters which can be used within CloudFormation templates and which can influence logical resources within those templates. Now we've got a lot to cover, so let's jump in and get started. Parameters, both template and pseudo parameters, allow input. They let external sources provide input into CloudFormation. For template parameters, this means that the human or automated process can provide input via the console CLI or API when a stack is created or updated. An example of this might be the size of the instance or the environment that the template is for, so for example dev, test or prod. Now parameters are defined inside a template along with the resources, and the values for those parameters can be referenced within logical resources also within that template, which allows them to influence the physical resources and or the configuration of those physical resources when a template is used with a stack to provision AWS resources. For every parameter that you define in a template, you can provide configuration for that specific parameter. You can define defaults for it, so if no value is explicitly provided, then that default applies. You can define allowed values, so maybe a list of instance types which are valid for the template. You can define restrictions such as the minimum and maximum length, or even allowed patterns. You can also define the parameter as using no echo, which is useful for passwords where you don't want the input to be visible when it's being typed. And then finally, each parameter can have a type. You have simple ones like string, number, or list, but you also have AWS specific ones which allow you to specify a VPC from a list or subnets from a list, and some of these can be populated, so from the console UI perspective, they're interactive based on the region and the account that you're applying the template within. Now you're going to be getting some practical experience of working with parameters in a future demo video. For now, I just want you to have a basic awareness. Now visually, parameter architecture looks like this. Parameters start by being defined within a CloudFormation template, and let's use this as an example. I've defined two parameters here, so instance type, which is a string, and it has a default of t3.micro together with a set of three allowed values. I've also provided a description which makes it easier to use from the console UI. And then second, we have instance AMI ID, which is a normal string type parameter with no allowed values, so this is simple free text. Now this example is part of a wider template which includes an EC2 logical resource. So if we load this into CloudFormation via the console UI, then this is what we might see, a user interface presentation of those parameters. At this stage, we enter values or we accept the default values and we move through the process of creating the stack. Conceptually, this means that the template defines things based on the resources declared within it and the interactive values provided via the parameters. So both of these are combined and are used to create the stack. It means that the stack creates physical resources based both on the logical resources and the effect on them which the parameters have. In this case, based on the parameter values, we would create an instance with one of three sizes and use a certain Amazon machine image. Now most of this applies to both template and pseudo parameters. The thing unique to template parameters is that the personal process provides the values into CloudFormation, either explicitly or by implicitly accepting the defaults. Pseudo parameters can be treated in the same way, but they're provided by AWS, so let's have a look at that visually. Now we start off with a familiar architecture. A CloudFormation template is used to create a CloudFormation stack. The template could be using the template parameters I've just been talking about. You don't have to pick one type over the other. Template and pseudo parameters can be used in a complementary way. With pseudo parameters, what happens is that AWS make available parameters which can be referenced, and these exist even if you don't define them in the parameter parameters section of the template. So conceptually, think of these as being injected by AWS into the template and stack. Now, an example of a pseudo parameter is AWS double colon region, and the value of this parameter always matches whichever region a template is being applied in to create a stack. In this example, US-East-1. Other pseudo parameters include AWS double colon stack ID, which matches the unique ID of the stack, AWS double colon stack name, which matches the name on the stack, and AWS double colon account ID, which is populated with the account ID of the account that the stack is being created in. So pseudo parameters, think of them like template parameters, but instead of being populated by a human or a process when creating the stack, they're populated by AWS. Now, both types of parameters are useful in ensuring that a template is portable and can adjust based on input from the person or process creating the stack. Static templates are much less flexible, and this functionality goes a long way to removing the negative aspects of static templates. From a best practice perspective, you should aim to minimize the number of parameters which you have which require explicit input. Now, this means, wherever possible, using defaults, and where possible, getting values from AWS rather than whoever is implementing the stack. In the videos which follow, as well as learning more about the features of CloudFormation which help with template portability, you're going to get the chance to experiment with all of those features in some demos. I'm introducing the theory first, and then you'll get the chance to experience it yourself. Now, with that being said, that's everything that I wanted to cover in this video, so go ahead and complete the video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next.